refer to one another with these words. Heavenly Father, in your Son, Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Help us to live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life. And strengthen this faith and hope in us all the days of our life through the love of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Can we then have 5 minutes to settle down and then we start the service? Okay. Thank you. I would prefer the two candles to be front and back. Bengcela. Bengcela kodwa abe lapha. Elinye libe lapha, elinye libe ngapha. So that angaphazanyiswa. Beka la. For the moment, let's just put them there. We have that 5 minutes now.
Thank you.
are about to start now, and I want to request Zuki and Buti to move into the shade, because you are going to... We open our service with hymn 14 from the Methodist Church. I will start it myself. Thixo akunangqaleko. Thixo akunangqaleko. Thixo akunangqaleko. Ukho endaweni zonke. Ukho ngamaxesha. Aya paya ezi. Kwenkwezine. Ukho wena ezulwini. Wabukade. Selo kona azinde kabiko zoda 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 zikli oke zonke utsicha lala konke uve Let me welcome you all to this, our last service for Professor Dieter Walter Welts. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I welcome you. Amen. Amen. This service will be conducted in three main languages, that is isiXhosa, English, and a bit of German here and there. So I want to say to our viewers who are on the live streaming program, welcome, Molweni, Dumelang, Guten Tag. We now want to observe the following rules. That is, all visitors who are coming to the service must be properly sanitized and wear protective clothing, and they must also listen carefully to my instructions, because we have only 1 hour. So if a speaker is on the floor, or there's a tribute, or a reading, we must listen carefully, because we want to give time to the family to pay their own tributes. So without further ado, I will request Mr. Zukile Vokwana to read the life statement for us. Last verse in that hymn, while he gets ready. Please stay out of the rain, Nwabi. Avoid the rain. Beke zonke shaba lalo konke ube wena ungapeli. Obe wena usahleli. Amen. Over to you, sir.
The life statement of Professor Dieter Welts. Professor Emeritus Dieter Walter Welts was born in the city of Königsberg in the former German region of East Prussia, to Walter and Hedwig near Heidemann Wells. Dieter passed away after a brief illness during the evening of the 5th of April 2020 in his adopted hometown of East London, after spending more than half of his life in South Africa. His memories of East Prussia were few and vivid, and while proud of his origins, he considered himself to be primarily a Humbeck native. He never returned to Königsberg. After completing secondary school at the Matthias Claudius Gymnasium in Humbeck, Dieter studied literature at the University of Humbeck, gaining an MA degree, followed by a Doctor of Philosophy degree in 1969. His early studies were in the field of medieval German literature and philosophy. For a short while in Germany, he worked as an educator at secondary school level before following his academic path. He left Germany for South Africa's shores in 1970 to begin his university teaching career as a lecturer in German language and literature at the University of Natal in Pietermaritzburg. After 3 years in Pietermaritzburg, he accepted a post as a senior lecturer at the University of Stellenbosch, where he stayed on a wine farm before being offered Professor of German Language Studies at Rhodes University in Grahamstown in 1978. At the time, he was amongst a group of unusually young senior academics, particularly at Rhodes. In 1993, he was awarded his second doctorate, that is the Doctor of Literature from the University of Pretoria, with the subject of his thesis being the seminal play Faust by German writer and statesman Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. He was a professor at Rhodes University for some 22 years. Dieter's way of thinking about society, social developments, and the behavior of the human race in general was stunning, and lifelong learning was his way of life, long before it became popular. Dieter had a compulsion to master new fields, and as a result, he made it his mission to get research grants for young academics, scholarships, and bursaries for his students. After retiring as emeritus professor from Rhodes University, he joined the University of Fortes Faculty of Law, serving as the head of the Department of Public International and Constitutional Law until he formally retired from all teaching in 2007. As head of department, he introduced Fortes students to the UN Moot Court. He spent time as a visiting professor of law at the University of Florida. Dieter's contribution to both South African and German intellectual culture were not limited to the classroom. His activities extended to long periods of journalistic endeavor, from facilitating collaborations between German radio broadcasters and township theater groups in the 1980s, to interviewing prominent authors and public figures like Bishop Emeritus Desmond Tutu and Nadine Gordimer, to name but a few, to editing the important academic journal Acta Germanica, to the German Settler Project, a series of ethnographic research interviews with descendants of German settlers in remote parts of the Eastern Cape in the late 1980s. His work on such projects and his later interest in constitutional law and the rights of citizens were products of both his strong sense of being intellectually and culturally a German, and all the privileges and perspectives accompanying that, as well as his deep sympathy for and interest in African peoples of South Africa, and specifically the Amaxhosa people. He understood the position of being simultaneously in exile and a native better than most, and he took delight in the usually esoteric historical eccentricities of South African life and culture. Importantly, Dieter believed not just in acquiring knowledge, but in transmitting it to others, both through the lecture hall and by creating opportunities for many South Africans to study in Germany and to participate in international fora. He used the duality of his life and identity as a German in South Africa to the advantage of many of his students. Until his retirement, Dieter was actively involved with the German Foreign Office's various international development initiatives, including serving as the University of Fort Hare's special representative for the DAAD from 2002 to 2005. DAAD is Germany's equivalent of the United States of America's Fulbright program. Appreciating the technical prowess of Germany's industries and universities, he enabled many young South African engineers to experience some of this through programs of study for them at the German technical universities. He also cultivated links with like-minded academics at the University of Essen, with whom he remained in contact for many years. He believed fundamentally in the pursuit of equality through education, and he served on Rhodes University's Transformation Committee through the 1990s. Although his Teutonic work ethic and sometimes uncompromising approach to those he saw as being responsible for systematic failures in the institutions which he worked in did not endear him to all. There are many beneficiaries of his efforts to improve others. Many of his students went to great things, from working for the HRC, the ICC, and the competition commissions, to senior roles in broadcasting and politics. Dieter leaves a diaspora of lifelong supporters in many parts of the community. Dieter enjoyed the outdoors, and during his time at Rhodes, he remained a member of the local golf club, spending many afternoons in the shimmering Albany heat on the fairways and in the rough. He was, however, a sportsman of modest talents by his own admission. He loved the Eastern Cape countryside, and for years kept a second home in the Amatola Mountains. Dieter cast his vote in 1994 for a democratic new South Africa, and in the last 15 years he enjoyed the gentle climate of East London. And as a true German and adopted South African, he was always fond of a cool beer on a warm day. Dieter is survived by his wife Nwabisa, children Franca, Andreas, Martina, Thomas, and Dietmar Edumisa, grandchildren Otto, Amy, Lucy, and Sebastian, and by his two brothers. To conclude, reading from Johann Wolfgang von Goethe's quotation, "If you treat an individual as he is, he will remain how he is. But if you treat him as if he were what he ought to be and could be, he will become what he ought to be and could be." Thank you.
My soul.
Thank you very much. Itobema. We now move forward to the tribute by Sinomta Qinisile. It's on tape. Thank you. May be seated.
Good afternoon to family and friends, both gathered there physically to support the family during this time, and those live streaming this from all around the world. My name is Sinomta, and I too, unfortunately, was unable to make it to the service today, but I thought it was very important that I share a few words about my uncle Dieter. Professor Dieter Walter Walz, a highly educated man with multiple qualifications in law and literature, a senior professor and lecturer who has conducted and published interviews with the likes of Bishop Desmond Tutu. Now, this is honestly a summary of the summary of the official summary of some of the things Dieter has done. But to me, he was just my uncle Dieter. The person who would meet us at the door to greet and welcome us in every time we would visit, and the person who walked us to the gate every time we left. Now, he was also known as Mr. Potato Salad, because everyone knows a Wurz dinner does not go down without Nobisa's famous potato salad. Now, I have known Dieter basically my whole life. Trouble for him began when I learned how to talk as a toddler. And boy oh boy, from the minute he would walk in, I would string all two sentences I know and talk his ear off. Three-year-old Sinomta would sit on his lap, rub his beard, and beg him to marry my mom instead. I'm so sorry, Nwabi. I would even warn him about the dangers of Candyman. Now, if you are a nephew, a cousin younger than Kanya, she would traumatize us with Candyman, and it was my duty to make sure that Dieter was safe and knew the dangers of Candyman. Mind you, all of this was done in isiXhosa, but Dieter being Dieter would sit there, listen to all my rambles as if it made sense to him. As I grew up, he became my uncle Dieter and Edumisa's dad. For as long as I can remember, Dieter was in charge of Edumisa's after-school pickups. Now, I have no idea what conversations they would have in the car, but I'm pretty sure they involved a shamrock pie. Every day, when Dieter would pick up Edumisa, he would buy him a shamrock pie and everyone else in the house. Now, this happened every single day without fail. This was followed by homework and answering all of Edumisa's never-ending, why this, why that, why this way, why not that way questions. And boy, oh boy, there were a lot of them. For most of my high school career, I wanted to become a lawyer. Now, I wasn't sure what kind of law I wanted to specialize in, but all I knew, I wanted to go into law. So naturally, when the opportunity arose for me to enter an international criminal court moot competition, I decided to go for it. This competition will be held in Germany and Poland, and I knew just the person who would be able to assist me. Dieter was the first person I thought of, as this required me to read up on case law and other laws and statutes, and I needed to write a 5,000 word essay for the prosecution team. Now, I knew this was not going to be easy. Without hesitation, he agreed, and I was thrilled because a whole law professor was my assistant. From my uncle Dieter to my co-chair and professor of law, a dynamic man if you ask me. I was selected as part of the 10 students who were able to go to Germany and Poland, and I was ecstatic. To say Dieter played a big part in me going would be an understatement, and I honestly couldn't have done it without him. One of the things I loved about him was his quick wit and humor. Many did not know how funny Dieter was, but he had quite a sense of humor. If you listened close enough, you would catch all the fiery things he would say that would make Nobisa exclaim, "Dieter!" Now, I sit here wondering who on earth is going to name all the different parts of my grandmother's house. Now, if you know Edimbaza, you know there's a place dubbed the Pondoki. This was all thanks to Dieter. My uncle Dieter, I cannot begin to describe how much you'll be missed. We will miss you dearly for all the patience of love you've shown us. Especially Upoki, who wanted to take pictures with you every 5 minutes, even though you're watching BBC News. We will miss the little dance and head bobs you will do when Edmiso was playing Drake loudly throughout the whole house. I will certainly miss you for always caring if I'm cold or not, even when I'll be wearing a turtleneck and the smallest bit of my arm was showing. Thank you for all the history lessons at the dinner table and always willing to assist wherever you could. But most importantly, thank you for being such a great dad to Edu and being Novisa's best friend, love, and confidant. We will miss you dearly. To my Nwabi and Edu, you have been blessed with some of the best years with Dita, filled with so much love, laughter, and travel. I know saying goodbye to a loved one is never easy, but I hope you find comfort in knowing that his memory lives on. You are both loved so much, and there is honestly nothing we wouldn't do to make it hurt a little less. On the days you find it difficult to get through, please pick up the phone and contact us. We are here for you, always. Rest well, Uncle Dita. Lots and lots of love. Sinomta. Good afternoon to family and friends, both gathered there physically to support the family during this.
Is that it? Okay, thank you. I like the humorous part about the Mr. Potato Salad and Candyman. Tatu Mabona, welcome. We're glad you're here with your family. And we now move straight ahead to the reading of the tributes. I suppose you know who that is, family. Ongwele, 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 uThixo, alikho. Ekama elihle njengalo alikho ekama elihle njengalo. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. I am Kanyisa Ngoyo, a friend of the family, and today I'll be reading tributes to Professor Dieter Veltz. The first tribute is from his student, Songezo Mapai. I was saddened to learn the news of the passing of the first person I ever called Prof, Prof Dieter Veltz. The year was 2005, and I was a second year law student at the great University of Fort Hays Nelson Mandela School of Law. Then I was enrolled in the constitutional law and administrative law modules as taught by Prof. Dieter. In the years before that, I had never had a professor of law. And so with Prof. Veltz, I had a teacher with age, experience, and wisdom to match the heaviness of the modules. Prof's classes were filled with stories, stories that could only be told by one of age, experience, and travel. Of German origin, Professor Veltz was soft-spoken, so it was hard to hear him speak, to the point that I'd have to sit in front of the class just to hear what his teachings were. And it was a study of concentration to get the true value of his lessons, and the true value was there. In that year, for the first time in my young university life, I got to experience an international guest lecturer in Professor Gerald Vell, the German criminal law expert. It was this supposedly meaningless visit by Prof. Veltz as facilitated by Prof. Veltz that planted the seed in my mind that the world was there for my taking. Over the years, this would be reinforced, and it has since come to pass. I am pleased to have had the chance to travel to Europe and North America to pursue my life's dreams and passions. And I trace the root of all of these travels to the one lecture where Prof. Val came from Germany to teach us. It was then that I knew I would one day return the favor elsewhere around the globe, and I did. One of the hallmarks of Prof. Volz was his truth and independence of mind and speech. In his teaching us about the Bill of Rights, he lived the freedoms enshrined therein by how free he was to speak his thoughts. Whilst it may not have won him many friends, he never did forsake his posture, even at a great expense to him. That is an abiding lesson for many. And I can never speak of Prof. Valls without remarking about my dearest Miss Foxy, who I got to work with as a student leader when she was the co-director of the East London campus of Fort Hare. I grew very close with Usis Nwabi and I'm still touched with her to this day, some 15 years after we first engaged in East London. Mine is only to wish Usis Nwabisa and Edumisa strength as they embark in a new chapter of their life. Time is going to be their best friend and most consistent friend as they look to navigate waters without their husband and dad, respectively. In doing so, I shall pray that they find renewal in the road that lies ahead and are bathed in constant love. Finally, as Prof. Valls goes the way many before him have, I wish that his soul rests in peace, safe in the knowledge that he has produced many scholars in men and women who are capable to advance society. Now I'll be reading the second tribute, which is from Jeff Opland, the visiting professor of School of Languages at Rhodes University. I last saw him nearly 40 years ago, and my memory has now dimmed with age, but Dieter stands out vividly in my mind. And I learned of his passing with the most profound sadness. We first met through our mutual interest in the literature of the European Middle Ages and grew closer in the decade we spent together as professors at Rhodes University. Dieter was a rigorous academic, wedded to the ideals and processes of scholarship and roused by colleagues who fall short of those high ideals. He was a man of principle, steadfast in his adherence to the code of fairness and justice, fearless in confronting those who violated that code. Above all, Dieter was my friend. A relationship that for him entailed unflinching loyalty and support. A relationship through which I benefited greatly from his guidance and wisdom. Lala ngoxolo mhlobo wam, rest in peace. The third tribute is from the German Consulate General in Cape Town. Dieter Valls came from Germany to settle in South Africa in 1970. Dedicating most of his career to German language and literature, he became professor of German at Rhodes University in 1978. At the time, most of his peers regarded German studies or Germanistik as an academic discipline far removed from the social and political context in South Africa, catering predominantly for German mother tongue speakers. In 1984, he introduced a separate stream, German as a foreign language at Rhodes, enabling a far wider cross-section of Germans of South Africans to embrace the subject. In this way, he facilitated critical engagement with contemporary debates in the country. Many other departments were soon to follow his example, albeit much later. He will also be remembered for translating prayers and writings of Bishop Desmond Tutu into German, as well as for his interviews with South African writers critical of apartheid. As professor of constitutional law at the University of Fort Hare, he contributed to the discourse of constitutional democracy in South Africa. Being familiar with political developments in post-war Germany, he was able to put developments in post-apartheid South Africa into perspective for a German audience. In terms of fostering dialogue between South Africa and Germany and achieving deeper mutual understanding, Dieter Valls, both as professor of German and as professor of constitutional law, made a lasting contribution. He will be sadly missed. Now the fourth and final tribute is from Nwabisa's sisters, Kanya and Spokazi Fokwana. Words cannot express our pain and sadness at writing this tribute. We were all supposed to be in Cape Town this week for Snopta's graduation, but we guessed the universe had other plans. We have known you for most of our adult lives when you were a cool dude that wore white linen pants and a gold chain around your neck. We remember you trying to institutionalize some form of order during family gatherings, a feat you never entirely accomplished. Nwabisa's side of the family is a high-spirited bunch that is prone to having loud and multiple conversations at the same time. You used to say, in that calm manner of yours, one conversation at a time, please. We would probably respond, Dita, choose the conversation that most interests you and follow that one. You would laugh and go lock yourself in your study for a couple of hours of peace. This proved to be one culture shock that you never fully subscribed to. Through it all, we could always count on your steadfast presence and support during the various phases of our lives. We will miss your soft-spoken wit that used to have us in stitches when we finally decoded the multi-layered humor. This would sometimes take hours. Thank you for loving our sister in all her madness and glory. In you, she found her intellectual and spiritual equal. You were a true partner in crime right till the end. We thank you for raising Edumisa to be the well-rounded, intelligent, and loving young man that he is. An achievement that we all worried was near impossible when he was a bratty child who used to force us to play Monopoly until he won and had zero regards for passing begin before collecting his 20,000. One time we went to bed at 6 a.m. playing Monopoly, and we still remember your shock when you found out about this and said, good God, were you guys playing for real money? We cannot thank you enough for the contribution and impact you have had on all of our lives. You have been our brother and an integral part of our family for 20 decades. You will be sorely missed. Till we meet again, Lala Ngoxolo, Kanya and Spokazi Fokwana. Thank you.
Thank you, Kanyisa. Can we have Imagine Coco before Dieter, Dietmar? After that song, it's Edumisa. Imagine by John Lennon. If you can't find it, we'll have a chorus. Okay.
Yes, please.
Slide. Oh, good. Let's have the slide.
Yeah.
Dumisa will be doing his tribute.
Is it fine? I'll just get straight into it. In the Hindu religion, the human life is split into four quarters of existence spanning 25 years each. This is known as the ashrama. Each 25 years is to represent the different stages of one's existence, the different chapters of their lives. And like a book or any novel for that matter, the story of each chapter is different but connects to the next. My dad was known across many different chapters of his life by his friends, family, and children. In those chapters spanning 81 years of existence, he touched many a heart, soul, and a face. Those chapters together, to mean all of us that knew him and had come to know him, is in a way to become the story of his life, a story that shaped us in one way or the other and defines who Dr. Professor Dieter Vults was and is to us. As a son, my father's son, and the youngest of his children, I knew my dad in the reflective stage of his life and had spent the better part of the last 20 years with him in the typical sense of being a child raised by a parent, despite him being a grandfather by the time I was 13. Dad, it may not have been smooth sailing. It may have not been smooth sailing all along. We may have fought and argued every now and then. But the next morning, it was always a hug and a cup of coffee. I remember during a particularly trying time in our relationship, you quoted Winston Churchill in reference to the relationship he had with his son. I love him, but that doesn't mean I like him. But love you did. From the Lego presents you got for me as a young boy, the snacks that always awaited me in your Ford almost every day after school, to the more firm discussions in my transitions to a young man while we were in Cape Town together for almost 2 years. Just the two of us and the many road trips to my rugby games across the Western Cape in the bitter cold, that is the Cape winter. It was during that time that you said to me something that has stuck with me since. There's no mark for sport. At a glance, such a sentence would be to refocus my priorities, for at the time my rugby career showed promise, but my academics needed much, much more work than my running on the field. One in 2016 and again where I would come first in my grade for geography and we had left Cape Town and returned here to East London, by the time that phrase had echoed in my mind again, that the achievements we are remembered for, or that one finds most significant, are the ones never thought possible. At the ages of 15 and 16, I was at a physical peak. My performance on the sports field, the track, was in no doubt for me, but we age. Our priorities shift, but what stays with us through such transition is our mind, our brain, and our memories. That was what that phrase had come to represent to me as a teenager, and as I near the closing chapters of my first 25 years of my life. I suspect, however, that was a concept you embraced over your whole career and life, and is something I admire about you, Dad. But nevertheless, my dad was a great supporter of Manchester United, and I remember him staying up past midnight watching the Champions League before chasing me back to bed if he caught me up at that time. This was when I was around 7 or 8. As a child, I was especially difficult to raise. My dad always listened to me and handled me patiently, maybe because he knew that if that didn't work, my mom would sort me out. Dad was very supportive of the choices I made and accommodating of their consequences. As a father, he was, in that sense, is something he had emphasized in the later stages of his life. In grade 11, when my marks were promising, I think he had realized that I was being too much of a nerd, and so he told me some of the more interesting stories of his life to inspire some curiosity outside of my studies, including the time he threw a brick into the window of his headmaster's office after writing his final matric exams, a symbol of appreciation, you could say, but not something I did, or when he was arrested at a bar in Pietermaritzburg during a police raid but let go with a slap on the wrist. These were the glimpses into my dad's younger self that I didn't know, but stories that showed that all of us are the accumulation of our experiences and not simply who we are because of where we are now. I have no doubt in my mind that my childhood was different to that of my older siblings, yet Dad, when I was younger, would take me to lunch if Thomas, Andreas or Martino were around. In such a space, I felt no exclusion, awkwardness of difference, because to all of us, he was Dad, our Dad, even if they were finishing high school and I hadn't even started primary school. Dad will always speak to me about my siblings and what they had done, almost as both a lesson to what I should and shouldn't do, that they had done what I had yet to do. My dad held a sense of foresight that bewilders me when I reflect on my time with him, the choices he made in my education, and how the sort of father I would experience in him were things he had thought about before I was born, things that had occupied his mind, and I am the sum of that, as my mother says. I was planned before I even existed, and so the rest is history, as they say. Dad, I love you. I'll miss your antics, your hugs, your curiosity, and your advice. It may have been tough somewhere along the road, but you showed me how to take the best out of life, and for that I'm forever grateful. Rest well and rest easy. You will always inspire me. In the words of William Shakespeare in Hamlet, doubt thou the stars of fire, doubt that the sun doth move, doubt truth to be a liar, but never doubt I love. Thank you.
Thank you, Dietmar. The mother tells me that Dietmar means prince of his people, and Dieter means hero of the people. So, siyabulela mhlekazi. And we now welcome any other people who have arrived. I'm told our Pavarotti or Questa is here, Toba. I call him DJ October. He will render his item just before the blessing at the end, Toba, after the sermon. We now move straight to the tribute by Mrs. Vokwana Wells. Manoaza, over to you, ma'am.
It was at Forte in February of 1998. During the visit by the former German president, Roman Herzog, that Dieter first saw me. He was with a group of happy students. And the picture of former German president Herzog standing with students and Dieter occupies a wall in our study. This picture is alongside a picture of a smiling four-year-old Edumisa and that of our former president, Thabo Mbeki. As Dieter put it, let him see what is expected of him, referring to Edumisa. It was at a time when Forte was the landing strip for academics all over the world coming into South Africa. The truth is that Dieter ticked all the boxes for me. He had a beard, not just any beard, but a red one. He had beautiful long legs. He was always dressed smartly, and his nails were always immaculate. I never knew that you could go and do your nails, but Dieter introduced me to that. His cynical wit always got Kanya and Snomta and Spato and Spokas into stitches. My mother would stand at the kitchen sink and say, hey, u Dieter kodwa kamameli, and would giggle, thinking of Dieter's wit. The most unfair thing that he ever did to me was that he never grew a single gray hair until he was 8. Every day of the last few years, he would watch me brush my hairline with a black mascara to hide my gray hair. And he would smile and say, I know, Abisa, as long as it works. Dieter never, ever, ever called me Voxy. At the time of meeting Dieter, I proudly labeled myself some kind of a feminist because I'd long made a few decisions, standing in the kitchen after a long day so as to please a man wasn't my definition of love. As a result, when I told my sisters Ulinda uSphokazi noKhanya about Udita, I didn't tell them about how handsome and intelligent he was. I bragged about the fact that he could cook and we did laundry together. Shortly before Dita's 60th birthday, he met that great man of foresight, my grandfather, L.T. Vogwana. For months, Dita beamed at how my grandfather called him the young, handsome man. So when Dita saw several historic pictures featuring my grandfather, he mumbled something unpleasant, and the following day, he made a point of taking the pictures for professional framing. These pictures hang in the room in which we are all sitting today to bid Dita farewell. This was probably one of those times when Dita said something really bad to me about my family and so forth and so forth, how much we didn't care about things and we didn't understand the value of things, that he really didn't care whether this was going to hurt me or not. Udita was clear from the onset ukuba he was Professor Vels. He was not going not to be Professor Vels. And the best thing I did for myself was to give him the respect of being a professor. For almost 4 years, we had a very clear division of emotions. There was Professor Vels, and there was my Dita, who wasn't just my lover, but my comforter and my best friend. Dita, of course, was in his element. I didn't question his views. I listened patiently to what he was arguing. I was just his queen, except, of course, I was suffering. I'd been long arguing as a person since I was about 12 or 13 in St. Matthew's. And all of a sudden, I had to listen to Dita and agree with what he was saying. This was not going to work. Of course, this helped me a lot because I had to read. And when Dita closed himself in the study, I would take it to Misa and would spend Sundays after Sundays in bookshops and coffee shops in Cape Town. And I was reading. So when I started to cross the professor boundary of thou shalt not challenge my views, arguments always ensued. And always ensued in the kitchen. Edumisa called these nuclear type arguments. But at the dinner table, would again agree. This was fundamentally important for me to argue back because we were raising Edumisa. Dita was my shelter. Dita was my gift of sanity. I am a mad person. Since I was 15, I knew I would never be umakoti. Since I was 16, I knew I would never do that slaving thing in the kitchen. And of course, by the time I reached 28, there were very few people of my age group who could understand that I thought in that way. The pressure was enormous. And of course, when I got involved with Dita, many questioned my reasoning for choosing, as they put it, such an old German man. Dita didn't get visibly emotional about this. Instead, it was his chance to tell me quite a lot of stories. I know quite a bit about his past life because of this. Because I would get home and I would say, you know, I met so-and-so. He said this. And he would go on. Dita was an amazing father. Dita adored bonke abantwana bakhe. Dita adored all of his children. He told me stories about Franka and how Franka referred to him as a Russian because of his beard and his red hair. It was the one thing that Dita gave me. And it was the one of the things I remember about him. When we sat at that hospital, he softly said to me, Nwabisa, are our children fine? Nwabisa, do they have food? That was Dita. He always worried about his children. Dita pampered Edumisa, and for 14 years, he threatened him with Prussian discipline, a wish he finally got when the two spent time together in Cape Town. Well, to say I slaved in the house the entire weekend during my first visit to them is an understatement, because Udita, instead of disciplining Edumisa to wash up in the kitchen, he actually went out, bought cups, plates, cutlery to last them for a month. That became his Prussian discipline for Edumisa. And when I protested about this, Dieter, you cannot do this. This is so wasteful. He retorted, well, he will have to find an option and a way to have lots and lots of money. Dieter was my love. We were an odd couple, both in the public eye and to our families. We were both fully aware of it. I called him baby. He called me sweetie. He was neither baby and I was never sweet. In spite of our age gap, we glued together. Whenever one of us ran into trouble, we stood fast. We were completely and always on a sailor's grip. Never, not even my friends, could actually talk me out of Dieter. I was really, really fond of him. Our oddness, of course, affected our son most. When Edumisa was in grade 5, for instance, for the first time, his peers endlessly teased him about his father's age and calling him and saying, "Nangu tatomkhulu wakho, there's your grandfather." The bullying stopped the day Dieter softly said to Edumisa, "Next time a boy says that, ask him if he even knows his father. Ask that boy to ask his mother where his father is." That was the end of that. That was Dieter. He didn't care what damage that said to the boy who was being told that. He was simply protecting Edumisa. Edumisa was Dieter's number one priority. He spent literally all of his time with him. I was able to pursue a career. I was able to work because Dieter was a full-time father, and Dieter had no qualms with that. I can only hope that the moments they spent together will build Edumisa's fort for life. My Dieter, my forward-looking German genius, has given me an amazing, amazing healthy life. My Dieter, my companion, my best friend. My Dieter, who in the last week continued to show his love as he got his students, my uncle, my cousin, my grandparents' grandchildren, my mother, my sisters and our children, because he called Andreas, Martina, Thomas, Edumisa, our children. And when I protested, he would say, I said our children. I will say Edumisa if I'm talking about Edumisa. Our children worked with me to bring together how we're going to do today. Today is my last service to you, love of my life. What can I say? Ndinebhongo ngabe jamane lam. Ndizikhomba isifuba xa ndisithi uDieter umyeni wam. Inene ngenene ndinguye nyani umfazi onjabane. Sozijike loo nto. Ngutata wosana lwam lo. Isn't it amazing? Is just it not amazing that thina sobabini we stand here today in this beautiful garden? When the hyenas of this country actually tried to take it all away from us. Me and you know our cathartic spiritual journey did not start last Sunday. It started long and long before April 5th. With all of my love, I do bid you farewell. Thank you, Dieter. Thank you for an amazing life.
Thank you, Nwabisa. Thank you to everybody. We now have to prepare for the short sermon. Mama Lisa will assist me with Izibele, Ngoma kaTamkhulu. Izibele zakho, Thixo. Izibele, that one. Have a short reading from the Gospel of John, chapter 11, especially verses 17 to 27. John chapter 11, verses 17 to 27. When Jesus arrived, he found that Lazarus had been buried 4 days before. Bethany was less than 3 kilometers from Jerusalem, and many Judeans had come to see Martha and Mary to comfort them over their brother's death. When Martha heard that Jesus was coming, she went out to meet him, but Mary stayed in the house. Martha said to Jesus, "If you had been here, Lord, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now God will give you whatever you ask him for. Your brother will rise to life," Jesus told her. "I know," she replied, "that he will rise to life on the last day." Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me will live even though they die. And all those who live and believe in me will never die. Do you believe this?" "Yes, Lord," she answered. "I do believe that you are the Messiah, the Son of God, who was to come into the world." Inkosi masikelele ukufunda kwezulayo ngoku nangona phakade. Amen. To Franca, Andreas, Martina, Thomas, and Dietmar, and Nwabisa, and the whole family, this short message of encouragement. I said to her on the phone, "Nwabi, the theme for that message is Jesus lives and Dieter lives." In my broken German, it says, "Dieter lebt, Jesus lebt." I am the resurrection and the life. Dieter, warrior of the people, lives. May I thank Nwabisa, my niece, and the entire family for this kind invitation to come and share a few words of comfort. It is a sign of the stressful times we are in that family members have to be invited, quote unquote, to family occasions, especially of this nature, because of the COVID virus and its attendant regulations. I am sure the home has tried its level best to comply in terms of permits, sanitizers, washing of hands, and everything else. I also wish to thank God for bringing Vox and Walter, Vox and Welts, V and W, sounds like Volkswagen, Dieter and Nwabi together, and gifting them with Edumisa. Note well, this service is being streamed alive to the four elder children who are in lockdown in Germany and the UK. Franca is in Berlin. Andreas is in England, Newcastle. Martina is in Deutschland or Germany in the city of Rotterdam. And Thomas is in Manchester in the UK. Guten Tag, my children, and willkommen. May I greet you in the mighty name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. You will appreciate my feeble attempts to speak a bit of Xhosa Deutsch. Masiqale ngelabadala. Thuthuzelekani maSwati nabantwana nabantu bakwaWelts. Akuhlanga lungehliyo. This is all part of life, the rhythm of birth, life, and death. Bayaphila bobabini. Uyesu, no prof. It's the time of sunshine and rain, joy and sorrow, laughter and weeping. Uyesu uvukile kwaye uyaphila. Hallelujah. Masisho sonke. Hallelujah. Notata ubhuti umalume utamkhulu umzala wenu uDieter uyaphila. Ukho kweli khaya. He is alive and well and smiling at us, Dietmar, as we shed a few tears. You see, with the dead people, Bau Mabona, it's like a class partition. They are standing on the other side and smiling and looking at us and saying, wow. Then gas baban tanda gangaga, ababant. I had my own issues with Dieter about the lobola bit, but that is fine, I got over it. Couldn't understand why this German chap doesn't play lobola and bring in the Makoti properly. Anyway, Dieter is in another form now. Ukwenye imo, your father, children, and Nwabi is alive and with us in spirit. Quote, to have faith is to be sure of the things we hope for, to be certain of the things we cannot see. It was by their faith that people of ancient times won God's approval. That's Hebrews 11, verses 1 to 2. Psalm 90, verse 10, so well read by a family member, reminds us that 70 years on earth is all well allocated. Sisabelo sethu eso. But because of God's boundless mercy, Lisa, and love, and recent advances in medical technology, we go up to 80 and 90 and 100. So, Mhlekazi yena, he was having his bonus 11 years. Some of us are turning 70 very soon, and so on. But Mzala, siyaphila kwezinsuku. Umakhulu Mamhlane at Queenstown is now 101, and she'll be 102 in November. Praise the Lord. Amen. We do reach 8 years with relative ease, as our brother and son-in-law Dieter did. We wafumana ibonus 11 years. Praise the risen Christ. We are so grateful for that extension of time and life. Danke schön, Jesus lives, uDeter uyaphila. The story of how our Lord Jesus Christ raised Lazarus from certain death is well known to many. What is of paramount importance is, number one, Jesus is told in advance, as we were told about Dieter, Lord, your dear friend Lazarus is ill. This is John 11, verse 3. But Jesus stayed where he was. Yes, he delayed for 2 more days. And I'm sure you and I would have dropped everything and rushed to East London or Bethany to do what we can to support our sisters, Mary and Martha, or Nwabi and Spokas. Why this delay, you may ask? To bring all glory to his Father in heaven and not to himself. Number 2, Jesus wept. Kwalila uYesu. This is the shortest and most powerful sentence in the whole New Testament. The question is, why did Jesus cry? Was he overcome by emotion? Probably. But the main point is that our Lord was showing the family, friends, and bystanders that he is human and natural. Men and boys in this room, it is good and therapeutic to cry. Don't buy that myth, tigers don't cry. Please, for your own sake and sanity, get into that side room or bedroom or toilet and let it all out. Have a good cry or sobbing session. After that, you will feel much better. It's all part of grieving and mourning. Highly therapeutic too. In conclusion, I know that Nwabi is panicking now and saying, Schnell, uncle, hurry up, tangi. But unbizu puti. Ango put lange ni mnatingu tangi. She's saying, quickly now, before the hour is over. Jesus lives and Dieter lives. He will continue to live in our hearts and minds, Professor Opland and colleagues from Fort Hare. Dieter will continue to be a good teacher, and a good teacher never actually dies. He or she just drifts off to an eternal sleep every time his or her students talk about him or imitate and remember him and his jokes. I didn't even know the fellow had a sense of humor. They are reviving and immortalizing him. Nakuba efile usatheta. Let us celebrate a life well lived. Let us hold on to those wonderful and beautiful memories. In the name of God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Rest in peace, D.W. Wells. Farewell, Auf Wiedersehen. It is well. With my soul, it is well, it is well with my soul. I requested 3 more minutes of extra time because there is this item by Toba and then the benediction, but the vote of thanks will be done immediately after Toba. DJ October. Yizamhlekas. Can you tell the chorus? Get closer along with technology. Simbona ngothando lwakhe. Simbona ngothando lwakhe. Simbona ngothando. Olwakhe uYesu ya uyamangalisa simbona ngotha olwakhe simbona ngotha olwakhe simbona ngotha olwakhe uYesu yamangalisa. Over to you, Toba. Thank you. Everybody was involved in the execution of this operation. Just before the pronouncement of the benediction, I have to indicate to Noabi and her team that since Dieter passed on, we have been in contact with many people. I want to thank the technical team, the DJ, is it Tando and Gogo? And then all those who were involved with catering and preparations, supporting Noabi in everything, and Dumisa. Niyabulelwa kakhulu. Welcome, Mama Kuti. I just saw you now. That is Toba's mother. We just want to say there'll probably be some catering of some kind after this. But our arrangements for cremation are for tomorrow at 10, am I correct? So we will disperse after this. The pallbearers will take Dieter back to the hearse, and then we will meet again tomorrow at 9:45 before we go into the to the cremation place. But that is as much as I can say. Let us bow our heads for the benediction. Balqine ingqondo nenhliziyo zenu. Nimazi nimthande uThixo nonyana wakhe uYesu Kristu Nkosi yethu. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit rest and abide with you and those you love, now and forever. Amen. Amen, 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 amen. Amen, 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 amen. Amen.